fence here. See, I didn't see any of this stuff last time that we came through here because we weren't at the bottom. Look at this gate. This is awesome. This is pretty incredible. I'm digging it right now. This is the way it's supposed to be right here. This is exactly the way it's supposed to be. It's telling me that there's bats. It's telling me that we need to take care of this place so we can all enjoy it. It's telling me don't keep a secret. It's telling me to have fun, but it's not telling me that you can't come see it. And that's what I like about this. Here's another sign telling us to... Now see, I hate when I see these shards stacked. I hate that. Don't stack them. Touch them, feel them, leave them where they're at. Don't stack them. It's kind of crazy. Let's find a rock and let's change our shoes and then let's get this adventure going, man. Tell you what, I'm pretty stoked. Now there's cavates, houses, all the way across these ridges. And then even up there, way up high. It's an incredible place. And if you get a chance to come see this, you should. The Verde Valley is absolutely stunning. It is stunning. And the Verde Valley people, the older people, the newer people are a little bit put off, I think. But the older people love to have people come see this stuff. Maybe they too much wreckage. But what an incredible place to go. Probably take the sunglasses off, switch to the regular glasses, and see what this journey, this adventure of Mindelef Cavates. Are you guys ready to go? Is it time to go inspect some cavates? You know, the nice thing is that I'm soaking wet, but that's actually okay. What's nice is I got a dry pair of shoes. Now that would have kind of been bad, but having a nice pair of shoes that are dry, that was a good move. I don't always get good moves, but as I plan these journeys, I plan on probably, I even thought about putting my backpack in a trash bag actually, and wouldn't have been a bad plan, really. It really wouldn't have. Now we got neighbors down here somewhere. I see my truck, but I heard them drive up. A lot of people do the river, they float the river, and be a lot of fun. It definitely would have been a lot of fun. So as we go up this journey into the ancient's home, how incredible is this? Gotta catch my breath a little bit. I haven't been hiking the trails like I normally do. So I'm gonna move my microphone down. Hopefully we're getting good sound. And let's get on this journey. Now one thing, a lot of these, there's bats in these, a lot of these places. So you're gonna get knocked down with the smell on some of these. But look at these caves, they're just, so what they did was, you know, they dug out in between the hard rock and the soft rock. And how incredible is that? Right there. I mean, this is just one of the hundreds of caves that are in here. And one thing, make sure that you watch. Look how big these were. These were really pretty nice. You know, they would have had, some of these would have had mortar walls. And let's see if I can get this light on. There we go, that's a good one. They're actually pretty good. That would have been a big room. Now this one has a little bit of a bat smell, but it's not terrible. Some of them are terrible. And these were holes here, which I'm guessing would have had beams going across. So I'm gonna try to get down here and I'm gonna walk this ridge and go back to the days of the ancients. You know, a lot of different groups traveled through these areas and it's really incredible. It really is. Watch out for these over rocks. Now, I've been in these before, basically the same. you can see how well worn this trail is. I mean, there's a lot of people come up here. A lot of wildlife as well. Still a great home for them. Look at this right here. Isn't this incredible? I love these things. I love this place. And there's some footprints. That looks like a bobcat size. And this is just incredible as you walk through. And you're just going back in time as you crawl in here. You see this stuff. And a lot of them come through like this. They'll go from room to room. That's a big room right here. It's where they would have had their fires. Wow. I just love this place. Really do. So incredible. And most of these you can walk through without walking around that cliff. You can actually walk through here. And these rooms will go from room to room to room. It's like that one. Isn't that incredible? This place is fascinating. Every time I come here, I just can't believe how cool this really is. Unbelievable. What a view they had also. Now, you know, a lot of people walking through this and then to this. So let's get over here and see if we can do the same. Wow, I should have went to, oh shit. So you don't want loose stuff on you. Should have went through the cave, the tunnel. Been a hell of a lot easier than doing this. This is not the most stable ledge I've ever been on. So I see, oh damn it. Well, gonna have to take a trip down there. Oh, it's not that bad. It's right over here. Don't carry loose items on you, as they say. Now, for any of you that know, we're on the southern end of the Cavates. Most of them run north and south, because that's the way the cliff face runs. But there's a room down here on the very end. There's two on the very end. There's one there, and there's one there. They're just fabulous. Let's get this out. One of my favorites right here. First thing I'm gonna do is make sure we look really hard for any any animals. That one smells pretty bad. We got bats in that one. You definitely know when you got them with bats. It's not a, you don't go, well, I wonder. There's no way to eat them. You know, this funny thing about that floor is it really sounded hollow. Look how incredible this is. I've got a bat right there. Just came in. I don't smell it. It's bad in here. This little condo back there. How crazy is that, boy? You see the dust is awful nasty. Tell you what an absolute incredible place this is. I tell you, every time I come here, it's kind of a new experience. And man, I'm glad you guys could come with me, because that's what makes this important to me, is that you get to come along with me. Look at this view, this window to the world right here. Isn't that crazy? Look at the houses above. I mean, this is really an incredible place. Pretty unbelievable. I love coming here. Yeah, look at all the droppings right there. That's bad. Bad for your... So you want to probably wear a mask when you come here. And you never know what you're going to run into in here. So be all careful. Let's get out this window right here. They probably were going to guess a little shorter. Not a lot of footprints, though. I don't see a lot. So there'll be a lot more when the snowbirds start rolling this way. But for right now, we got this place to ourselves. How incredible is that? Just have to make sure we find our backpack when we leave. Well, we're going to have to find a backpack or we're not going to leave. The keys to the vehicle in it, so. Which I hate to do that, but you do what you got to do. Look at this journey. Now, we've been up there. Imagine living up in that. How incredible would that be? Unbelievable. Now, there's where we're at. I came this way to show you that window. Now look, there's no footprint in here at all. There's where we were at, right there. Isn't that unreal? Look at this place. This place is absolutely incredible. It'd be pretty cool to have a place named after you. Cosmos was a hell of a guy. And I tell you what's kind of funny is, you know, most archaeology seemed to have died after him and then really hasn't picked up, you know, for years. Got a few shards, not a lot. If you do find shards, just leave them. Pick them up and look at them, though. But just don't stack them on rocks. Let people find their own experience. I'm going to travel up this trail. It's getting a little warm out here now. We'll get another bath. We'll get two baths for the day. Down that point. That is totally unbelievable. Home's over here. What, the morning sun or the evening sun? This guy over here gets both. This would be in the, if I was the king, it's where I'd be, down here. morning sun and evening sun in the penthouse right here. How cool is this? This would have been the king to me, as far as I'm concerned. I don't know that to be a fact. I'm just saying, if I was the king, though, you know, look how short that distance looks. Maybe that's a spot right there too. Maybe that's an easy place to get across, actually. Look at that. Because I can see the water, which means that it doesn't look very difficult. Now, it's going to be deeper down there, but I don't care as long as I've got my equipment up high. That might have been the spot. And if it is, that'd be where the bathrooms are at, right there, which is kind of cool. That'd be an easy way for you to say, hey, that's a great way to get in and out of here right there. We'll probably come the way we came only because we know it. But just saying, there's an opening, and you don't see too many openings in the thicket with no really brush. We might try that anyway. We might try that because that way I could just tell you, hey, there's the bathrooms. When you get at the top of the bathrooms, you can go right through there and then straight up. But then again, we'll check that out though. We'll go down and look at that. But look at this penthouse down here. Look at this, how incredible this was. Look at these rooms. You know, I'm guessing those were beams in the walls for to hang stuff, maybe even some type of bedding. Smaller rooms, probably granaries to some degree. This is one of my favorite. Look at this pit right here. Isn't this incredible? Now this has got a lot of footprints through here. A lot of people have traveled through this to this point. How crazy is that? This is just an incredible place. Look at this in the hole on the floor. Right there, what I'm guessing is the beam would have gone across where they would have cooked. Some stupid vandalism. But you know, they were coming here, you know, right after Cosmos did. A lot of people saw what he did and came here, came in these places. We got to crawl through there. Be criminal if we didn't. Let's get it lit up. And look, there's a road right there. It's kind of crazy to me. We have this unbelievable area. It's that close. Now, I've thought this was some type of well or something. I mean, not sure what that is, if that's food storage, but these go all the way along this ridge. It's really incredible. There's a lot of trails. There's a lot of, so there could be, that could be how most people get across here, is running that way, not where I went. Probably it's a little deeper, but they're probably using boats to get across. Let's kind of work our way up through here. Wow. Thank you. guessing these are granaries right here. What I'm guessing. So I think it's time to get across that creek again. Time to put the wet, nasty shoes on. What a beautiful day this is. Unbelievable. Huffed and puffed a little more, sorry about that, but you know, getting back at it, it's work, but it's work that definitely pays off. Look at that view. I think this is exactly where we came through at, actually. I think we came right through here. As a matter of fact, I think this is the place. Might have been over there, actually. That looks pretty heavy right there. Well, that looks like pretty close to it. This looks like where I came out at right here. So let's get the shoes up, get the pack up. I think I came through here. Okay. Let's go. Oh shit. That sucked. Well, now what I want to do though is not fall. Man. Well, that was interesting. There goes a bottle. Don't want to litter. So I'll hold on to that. So let's get to trucking. Well, how interesting was today? Tipsy right here, a little tipsy. Water's extremely clear though, extremely clear. Wow, what an incredible day today was. Man, tell you what, this is just an incredible place. And you know, they want you to come here. This isn't one of them, don't tell anybody, it's a secret. Well, if you want to get wet, get in and see what Hohokam and Sanagua, ancient cultures, what they used to be like, where they used to live. Can you imagine what it would have been like? This river is beautiful, it really is. And even though I thought it would be lower, that means they've got a constant water flow, which is unbelievable. And wow, what a great, great day. I want to appreciate everybody that donates to me. You know, make sure you get on the Tuesday night live chat, engage. It's cool that we've got kind of like a family now, but the family can expand. It could be as many people as wanted to be there. And it's a great experience to be able to come to do this and then be able to talk about it on Tuesday show or whatever you guys want to talk about, anything that has to do with history per se. What a great day. Please, if you can, donate to Patreon. If you can, donate to the live show. What I want to try to do is not have ads on any of my videos, is what I'd like to do. All the new stuff that comes out, no ads. I'm sick of ads just like you are. We just got to be able to pay for this somehow. So I appreciate the donations, because without you guys, I wouldn't be sitting out here in my stocking or my feet. I wouldn't be out here. I'd be in a cubicle wanting to hang myself. You don't want that.